Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're looking at something special from Esnix, which is a company or a knife maker from the US, from Florida, called Evan Nicolaitis. And this is one of his Silverline production models. He has the Silverline where he offers some of his designs in a production collaboration with Riyadh, and it is his I think one of his first releases is this one here. This is the slip joint version of his Beer Buster Junior model. You can see here the beer bottle inlaid as a shield just on one side, and then you got, of course, the bottle opener in the back. There is also a front flipper version of this knife available, and they are part, all of them are part of the Silver Line. As you can see, they're marked on the tang. And then you see the Esnix logo. All of them you're getting in this very nicely done kind of light gray pouch with the Esnix logo. And Evan Nicolaitis usually makes absolutely gorgeous slip joint folders in a custom sense. So he's a custom knife maker that won a couple of awards. I believe 2022 he won best custom slip joint. So he's a very highly regarded custom slip joint maker. And he made his designs available in the Beer Buster Junior here together with Riyadh in a production sense. And if you follow my channel over the last couple of years, you know that because of this company right here, Jack Wolf Knives, I actually got quite heavily into slip joint folding knives. Before that, I had one here and there, mostly of the Lion Steel variety. And since I have gotten these Jack Wolf knives, I'm really invested into some gorgeous slip joint, most of them, of course, from Jack Wolf knives, because I think they're the best in the business. But from time to time, I like to check out what else is there on the market, and I think these were available before Jack Wolf knives came onto the scene. And they are made by Riyadh, and Evan Nicolaitis has some gorgeous designs, so I wanted to check it out, and I was able to get this here in a trade, so I didn't have to kind of pay out of pocket for it, because these are also quite expensive folders, like the Jack Wolf knife slip joints. And here we also have the even more expensive Damasteel version of the bottle, the Beer Buster Junior. So before we get into any comparisons and things like that, let's take a look at the specs here of the slip joint version of the Beer Buster Junior. You can see here a very nice slip joint. So we have an overall length here on the Esnix Beer Buster Junior of 15.5 centimeters or 6.1 inches, with a blade length of 6.7 centimeters or 2.64 inches, with a cutting edge of around 6 centimeters or 2.36 inches. In this version, we have this gorgeous Damasteel. I don't really know which pattern that is, probably Thor or something like that, but if somebody knows, let me know what pattern these actually come in at. I think all of the models in the Silver Line have a Damasteel option. And then we have a hand length of 9 centimeters or 3.54 inches. The other steel option is M390, and these are made by Riyadh together with Esnix, who provides the design here. And as I said before, there is a slip joint version, which we have here. And then there is also a front flipper version that also sports a pocket clip. Weight-wise, we're looking here at 60 grams or 2.08 ounces, so nice and lightweight, doesn't feel overly heavy. Size-wise, for my 7.5 sterile glove hand, very comfortable, full four-finger grip, as you can see here. Also, how they kind of executed the bottle opener here in the back, it's not going to poke into your hand when using it in any kind of way, so that's really well executed. And of course, no side-to-side play, and it is a slip joint, so no locking mechanism there. Price wise for the standard kind of handset in M390 version, there is also available in a couple of different micarta scales. Here we have the black micarta, and then there's also a full titanium one with kind of engraved beer bottle logo, and those go for $265. And for the Damasteel version that we have here, that's only available in this combination, we're looking at $345, so about $50 more expensive than a comparable model from Jack Wolf Knives. And as you know, the newer Jackoffs model also have different handle materials and don't offer micarta anymore. So very interesting size, actually quite a great size if you talk about a slip joint folder, kind of a backup folder without any clip or anything. Of course, here with the S-Nix, you don't get any kind of slip, but a slip of this size would certainly fit this well. That's also one of the benefits of having a Jackwolf knife, to get kind of the whole package to get you started, but also to just kind of drop this into the pocket, since it's the micarta version. Scratching up and things like that won't be a big issue. In terms of overall fit and finish here on this kind of Riyadh made folder, we actually have a very nicely done fit and finish. A thing I would love to see is to have kind of hidden screws, so they could just put these screws here on the inside and maybe have some more in line, but I just use the same screws for the back spacer and spring, so it looks a bit more modern in comparison to something like here, for example, the Little Bro Jack, where we have the kind of screws in line like you would see on a traditional folder, and then you have the actual screws for the back spring and everything underneath the scales. So that's something you can appreciate if you look at them closely. That's certainly a difference there. Of course, you have a easy access pivot, that's nice. We have large Torx heads for the construction right there. Overall fit and finish is good, but not perfect. You can see here, for example, that there are some not perfectly lined up matches between the titanium blasted liners and the micarta handle scale. Not anything big, but you see that there are some inconsistency there. And here we can also see nicely centered. Also the very nicely satin finished a back spring, very similar actually to how a Jackwolf knife does their back spring right there. So that's very similar. We have a little bit of lighter bead blast on the titanium there. And also the kind of position of the back spring in the half stop position. It's nice and flush. Completely open. Again, nice and flush right there. And of course you can see the gorgeous Damasteel pattern also on the spine of that blade. Here we have a flat ground blade, which is also something different if you compare it to a Jackwolf knife, but of course the Damasteel pattern just looks absolutely amazing. Love the swedge at the top. Is a drop point blade shape, looks a bit like a salt buster or something like that. You have the one-sided nail nick. On the other side, it's sterile, just says silver line. In terms of walk and talk, it certainly is not as snappy or as defined as something from a Jackwolf knife. You will see the comparison later. It is a bit more sluggish. It works. It certainly has an okay walk and talk, but it's not something to rave home about. And of course, because of the design of the blade, it's a blade that pretty hides quite a bit in the handle. It is pinchable, but you kind of always need a bit of your nail there to actually get to your blade. That is just a design thing, of course, but overall that is something that over time can be a bit annoying if you don't like to use your nail for that. But overall fit and finish is very well done. I love the option for the Damasteel. I would love to see Jackwolf knives that also offers a Damasteel option, of course. But that would be quite a bit of a departure from what we have seen so far. But you never know with Ben Belkin. But as we are talking quite a bit in terms of comparison to Jackwolf knife slip joints, let's take a look how they stack up against some Jackwolf knives. We have seen before already the new Little Bro Jack, and you can see here what I meant in terms of difference in walk and talk. I think you can see that for yourself, that there is certainly a difference in terms of the defined nature of the snappiness. Absolutely gorgeous, this little project, probably one of my favorites from the lineup so far. And if you take a look at both of them, you can see size-wise they are very, very similar. You got a pretty much a broader blade here, and also quite a thinner cutting edge with the kind of full height hollow grind that you get here on the S90V blade. So that's certainly something different in terms of the cutting performance. I certainly notice a difference between the hollow grinds here and the flat ground, pretty kind of thin blade that we have on the S-Nix. You can also see that the kind of cutting edge is certainly thicker, or the thickness behind the edge is certainly thicker here on the S-Nix Beardbuster Junior. If you take a look at the thickness, we are very close there actually. None of them have clips. Of course, you get the nice inlaid shield that is really well done, but I would love to see it on both sides right there. Seams are imperceptible. That's really a thing that just Riyadh absolutely knows how to pull off. Then some other Jack Wolf knives. Here we have the Pioneer Jack, which has also kind of more of a hidden blade in the handle. Certainly a larger one, but very similar in terms of the overall design, as you can see. Both of them are more of these farmer's knife or saltbuster patterns, as you can see. But here we have a hollow grind, of course. So size-wise, very close to your little bro jack, which is a great size for a slip joint folder, especially for some kind of a kind of backup folder. And of course, benefit here is you have the slip as well, and that's all covered in the $299 that you're getting. That you can get one of these slip joints by Jack Wolf knives from, and these are S90V if you get one of the newer ones. And the last Jack Wolf knife I want to compare it to is also one of the shorter ones. This is the laid back jack, a sway back pattern, and you can see this is slightly larger than the Beardbuster Junior by S-Nix. And just if you're not into slip joints, but I think this is certainly intended for people that are not kind of hardcore slip joint collectors. This is more for the kind of modern knife user that likes to have a nice slip joint as kind of a backup. We have here some other comparisons. This is the Button Lock Elementum 2. And here we have the CGRB Pyrite with the Wharncliffe blade. And you can see, of course, going to be shorter than both of these knives. So certainly an interesting offering here in collaboration with Evan Nicolaitis and Riyadh. But as I have experienced this, to kind of confirm my certainly a little bit biased opinion that you cannot get any better modern slip joint or modern traditional knife than Jack Wolf knives at the moment. I'm still convinced that that's a true statement. I really like some of the things that they have done here on the S-Nix. I like the kind of added thing, the cheeky thing with the bottle opener. They have integrated that really well. Fit and finish is done good, but not as well as on the Jack Wolf knives, in my opinion. And I love the option to have a Damasteel blade. I think that looks absolutely gorgeous. And overall, I just like the kind of more defined kind of, more kind of hard cut edges, and kind of more overall refined thing you get here when you have one of these Jack Wolf knives in the hand. Both are great, but in terms of what you're costing, I certainly would go for the Jack Wolf knives. Also, this is a much more kind of usable blade steel. If the S90V is absolutely amazing to use and carry these on an everyday basis, stays sharp for very long, and the action here is just leaps and bounds better than on this particular version of the S-Nix. It's not bad, but certainly does not give you the same kind of experience you have with something from Jack Wolf knives, especially the Little Bro Jack. I'm an absolute big fan. I love this size and this particular model. Very happy that they came out with those in November of this year. So this was my review. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. Put all your questions in the comment section below. Let me know which Damasteel pattern that is, and check out all the links in description. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.